So 10th class, today our concept is margin and padding property. Margin and padding property. One of you can come here if you want. Anybody can come here if you want. Clear? So what is margin? Imagine your notebook and you see left margin, right margin, top and bottom. Margin in simple language means the distance between the edge and the text. Like this is the paper. This is the paper, okay? And margin is how much distance your text has from the edge, this much gap. This gap is called margin. Margin is of four types: left, right, top, and bottom. Left, right, top, and bottom. Okay. Now, how to set the margin? We can set the margin by specifying the value in pixels. Right? Offline class, am I clear? Online class, am I clear? By specifying the value in the pixels. Right? How to write the margin property? I make a web page over here. HTML body H1. I give the title seasons. Okay, clear? Then I give the next heading in H3. I make a list. I make a list. UL type equal to disk. Okay. First is rainy season. Next is summer season. Next is winter season. Okay. Then we have is spring season, right? So here I close the list. Okay. Then at the bottom side, I use H4. We should welcome and enjoy every season. Every season. Right? So this is a small coding which I have created in front of you. Clear, 10th class? Now I will be setting the properties using the external CSS. So for that, what I will be doing, I'll be taking head tag. And inside the head tag, I'll be taking link tag, rel equal to style sheet, type equal to text oblique CSS, okay? And href will take the name of the CSS file. And here I am saving the CSS file with the name sample1.css. I close the head tag. Close the head tag over here. Clear? Yes, offline students, am I clear to all? Now, here I close the H4 tag. And here I close the body tag. Here I close the HTML tag. right? I just indent it. Right? So this is my HTML code. Now let us frame the CSS part. I save the coding under documents with the name season.html. Offline class, have you finished typing the coding? Shall I start the CSS part? Hurry up, please. Hurry up. Be fast. So now I am opening one new file where I'll be creating the CSS coding. Okay. Don't worry. I'll show the coding again when I'll finish the CSS part. First tag which I want to format is body tag. Here I am taking background color as silver. Let us specify margins here. Margin hyphen top. We can now see the LCD. For 2-3 minutes, just observe the LCD. Margin top, I am giving 30 pixels. Margin bottom, I am giving 30 pixels. Margin left, I am giving 20 pixels. And margin right, I am giving 20 pixels. Okay. These are the properties with respect to the body tag. Then I have H1 where I specify the color as red, right? Font family, I am giving Arial. Then font size, I am giving 60 pixels. Okay. Then font style, I am giving italic, right? And font variant, I am giving small caps. But a small caps means small capitals. Small capitals. If your browser does not support the small caps value, it will display the text in uppercase, normal uppercase, normal capitals. Okay. So font variant has two values, normal and small caps. If browser support it, it will display in small caps. Otherwise, it will display in normal uppercase. Got the concept, Chayang? Okay. Now comes the concept of padding. Bete, in table tag, I explain you one attribute, cell padding. What was cell padding? The gap between the cell content and the border of the cell. The gap between the cell content and the border of the cell. Right? That gap is called cell padding. Similar padding is used here. How much gap is there between the content and the border? Border mein aur content mein kitna gap hai? That is the padding. Padding is also of four types. Top, bottom, left, right. Just as we have margins. Okay. So I specify here padding top 20 pixels, padding, bottom, 20 pixels, padding, left, 20 pixels, padding, right, 20 pixels. Okay. And I am specifying one background color here also. Clear? One background color in the entire page, that is silver. This background color, which you can see I have typed here, it specifies the background color of the heading. That will be yellow. And when the heading will be displayed, it will be having the padding property set with top, left, right, bottom, all 20. Well, right? Side by side, you keep typing the properties in a separate file and name the separate file as sample1.css. One file you have typed, HTML file, save in documents. The HTML file you save in documents by giving the name season.html. Then make a second file of CSS and give the name sample1.css. This file which I am making in front of you. Okay. Till then I type the other property for UL. Background color. Forest green, color of the font blue, okay, font size 50 pixels, font weight bold. Clear? Online class, am I clear up till here with all the properties? So these are the properties set to the list, UL list. These are the properties I have specified for the heading element. Okay. And these are the properties I have set for the body tag. Right? So please be fast in typing. Online class, any doubt? Yes. Yes, Arman, unmute yourself.
Sir, wo font variant wala samajh nahi aaya.
Font variant is the property that displays the text either in normal, either in small capitals. One you have capital in uppercase, one you have capitals in small cases. Okay, am I clear? Small case capitals. Up till here, any doubt? Yes. Padding. This is padding. In table, we use cell padding. In CSS, it is padding. Margin is distance of text from the paper edge. This is the paper. This is the edge of the paper. How much your text is far away from the edge? Padding is how much your difference is between the border and the content of the cell. Border aur jo aapka data hai, usme kitna gap hai. You put something in border. You put some text inside the border. How much that text is at distance from the border? That is padding. Clear? this much work is done. Now at last we have H4. So for H4, I have only these properties, color, color I should take purple, right? Font size I am taking 40 pixels, text align center, text decoration underline. Okay, so I am saving this page with the name sample1.css, right? So let us see the browser view and see our output. Okay, see here, bete. Just see the season is printed inside the background color, having background color as yellow. See the gap from where the background color yellow is starting. Little away from the margin. If I increase the margin, I increase the margin from 40, right? Also 40. Okay. See. डिफरेंस नोटिस किया आपने, जहां मेरा माउस पॉइंटर मूव कर रहा है, दिस इज मार्जिन. द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम वेयर दिस बैकग्राउंड येलो कलर यू कैन सी इट इज स्टार्टिंग एंड दैट इज एज. ओके, क्लियर? नाउ इफ आई इंक्रीज द पैडिंग वैल्यू, have you noticed? The distance of this content with the border. I increase it more. I make it 50 from the top, 50 from the bottom. Now carefully see the change. Did you observe it? I can bring the text heading in the center by giving align property. Okay. Not to apply on the body, I apply in H1, right? Now see the output. Now see the final output. Yes, online class, is the browser view clear to everyone? Offline class, have you typed the coding? Finished the coding? This is a CSS part. Check it on LCD. You can set properties from your own side also. It's not any hard and fast rule that what I have set, you have to set the same properties. You can set from your own side also. Clear? अंडरलाइन फ्रॉम टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन, टेक्स्ट डेकोरेशन. Yes, online class, any questions? Any queries, online students? Yes, offline class, any queries? How many of you have finished typing offline class? Hurry up, bete, hurry up. This is H4. You can set any properties as per your convenience. Clear? I hope the role of margin and padding is clear, online class. Okay. Now, let us proceed to the next concept. Now, in the next concept, suppose I have 4 links. Are you still typing offline class? Suppose you don't want to give the margin separately like this. Okay, top, bottom, left, right. Okay, so you can set the margin at one time only. Margin colon 20 pixels, 20 pixels, 30 pixels, 30 pixels. See here. How browser will treat it? The first value signifies top margin. The second value signifies right margin. Third signifies bottom. Fourth signifies left. Top, right, bottom, left. If you are not specifying separately the properties, margin top, margin bottom, margin right, and margin left, you can set the values like this by giving space in between. The browser will treat the first value for the top margin, second value for the bottom right margin, third value for the bottom, and fourth value for the left margin. Am I clear? This is also the method to specify the margin. Same is for padding. Same is for padding. Like you can give 20 pixel top, 30 pixels right, 20 pixel bottom, 30 pixels left, and then semicolon. Okay, first value for the top, second value for the right, third value for the bottom, and fourth value for the left. Am I clear to all? Any queries, online class, offline class, any queries? Now, in the next concept, I have one situation here. Suppose I have 4 links. Indoor games, outdoor games. Okay. Hobbies and cooking. I have 4 links: indoor games, outdoor games, hobbies, and cooking. I want to show these 2 links in some separate color, in red color. These 2 links in green color. My target is these 2 hyperlinks, I want to show in red color. And these two hyperlinks, I want to show in green color. So, in another way, I can say, this is my one category. This is my second category. I have grouped one category in one group, second category in the second group. What all properties I apply to this group, it should be applicable on all the elements which are inside this group. If I say that I want to give a red color t-shirt to all the students having name starting with A, तो रेड टी शर्ट उन सभी को मिलेगी जो उस ग्रुप में आते हैं जिनका नाम ए से शुरू हो रहा है. वो एक ग्रुप बन गया ना. तो अगर मैंने कोई चीज अप्लाई की है उस ग्रुप में, तो जो जो एलिमेंट उस ग्रुप के अंदर अवेलेबल है, वो प्रॉपर्टी उस पूरे ग्रुप के ऊपर एप्लीकेबल है. अगर मैंने रेड कलर यहां पे लगा दिया इस ग्रुप में, तो जितने भी लिंक्स इस ग्रुप के अंदर हैं, वो रेड कलर सभी पे अप्लाई हो जाएगा. यू अंडरस्टैंड ऑनलाइन क्लास, यू गॉट द मीनिंग व्हाट आई वांट टू से? यस ऑनलाइन क्लास. ओके, सिमिलरली व्हेन आई वांट टू गिव द ग्रीन कलर टू दिस ग्रुप, ऑल द एलिमेंट्स व्हिच आर इनसाइड दिस ग्रुप, they will get green color. All the students having name starting with C should get orange color t-shirt. So all the students of C name having name with the C, they will get orange t-shirt. Wo sab pe apply ho jayegi. To achieve this target in CSS, a special attribute is provided that is called class attribute. Okay, it is used to apply the style rules to all the elements related in a particular group. Okay, I'll be continuing with this topic in the next upcoming lecture.